In front of the fourth largest crowd in UB history, the Bulls get their 22nd straight win at home, 90-76. I'm Paul Peck with Will Regan. Welcome to our postgame show on ESPN Plus, joined by Bulls head coach Nate Oates. At one point, your team is down 18 points in the first half of this one, Nate. What happened? What were they able to find? What were you able to help them find to come back and dominate the second half and get a win?
I mean, it was our defensive energy, really. I mean, we just had to pick it up on D. Their shooting percentage was ridiculously high in the first half. They were shooting 56%, 42% from three. So if you look from first half to second half, you know, they got down to 29% in the second half. I just thought we picked up our defensive intensity. Carruthers obviously helped there when we made the run to cut it from 18 down to 5. When he came in the second time, I thought he gave us great energy. We got some runouts, you know, and cut it to 5. It was huge. It was only 5, you know, when it was up to 18 and then cut it to 5 at the half. Now we're in business. We need a 2-possession game. Let's come out and let's get back to business and do what we do.
So the 8-minute media timeout, you called the timeout, you got the guys together, you're down about 18. What do you tell the team there? Because that's really when you started to turn it around at the defensive end and create your own energy.
I had to do the math for them and let them know they were down 18, for one. I don't know if they realized how bad it was at the time. I mean, I just said, like, you know, we can't keep giving up open shots. We're getting killed on the glass at the time. But just all the effort stuff, and I don't really have an answer for it because I thought, we had a pretty good week of practice. And, you know, Carruthers was banged up. He hadn't practiced all week. That might have been part of it. I think he had determined, he's just going to fight through it. CJ's shoulder, he didn't score in the first half. So for him to come up with 18 in the second half, I just think some guys had to decide, like, this is going to be a tough game. It's not going to be easy. We're going to suck it up and figure out a way to get this thing done.
Will and I were talking about a key moment in this game, which was at the end of the first half, the technical on CJ, but maybe, as Will thought, construed as a little disrespect by Austin towards your best player, and then right back, Carruthers draws the charge on Austin, gets the foul, and then Austin gets his fourth at the beginning of the second half. Kind of those couple of minutes of time, how important were they for maybe getting your team's attitude right and clearly getting one of the best players in the MAC in foul trouble?
Yeah, I mean, he's supposed to be one of the top three players according to the analytics sites and stuff in the MAC. So for him to only play 23 minutes, and be in foul trouble kind of when he's playing a majority of those 23 minutes was huge. Thought Carruthers, that charge at the end of the half, was huge. Then Jeremy with that rebound, he picks up his fourth right out of the gate. So that was big, and then we fouled him out. I mean, they kind of had to play him. They were scrambling, forced to play him, otherwise they were going to lose a game. Then they played him, he picks up his fifth, and we took advantage of it. I thought they still played hard. I mean, those kids played really hard. They cut it to 4 on us there late without him. So they were Roundtree's good. I mean, obviously they got two of the better guards in the league. So, I think Perkins in the second half took advantage early with their lack of size, which helpful. We can get some interior scoring with him in there.
All right, finally, Nate, say something about the fourth largest crowd in UB history that was loud.
That was
even
awesome.
When you were down, they were into it, and they really seemed to help your team get back.
No, it was great. I mean, I think it was great. A lot of them came for the women's game, so it's great for our women to play in front of a big crowd. We didn't want to disappoint, 6,500 people with the effort we gave in the first half. So we did talk about that at halftime. One of them, it wasn't me, one of somebody in the locker room talked about the crowd out here, and this isn't what they came to see. So hopefully we gave them a better 20 minutes there in the second half. I mean, it's awesome to play in front of this crowd. We love what Buffalo's doing for us. The community at large is supporting us, so we're going to keep playing hard for them.
All right, congratulations on the 20th win of
Thanks,
the year
fellas.
For the 8th time in school history and the 4th time in the last 5 years.
So
and our player of the game, Will Regan, Jeremy Harris, was a big reason for that. 19 points, 8 rebounds. We'll even mention your 6 assists. Jeremy, you're getting a nice
appreciate
round of
it.
Applause here, aren't you?
Appreciate it.
Again, take us through the point in this game had so many twists and turns, and your team had not come back from a bigger deficit than 13 points all year.
Right.
18 wasn't enough for Central Michigan today.
Right. I mean, Coach got on us real hard on halftime, of course, because we was down by 18 in the first half. But, we just stayed together and kept playing as a team and grinded out some stops, and we came back.
Right, Nick's not playing in the first half. CJ, shoulder bugging him a little bit. You're in a shooting slump. How do you kind of respond? Like, what are you doing to get out of that, telling yourself? Because obviously you stepped up there in the first
half. I mean, nothing special, just really putting in work all week. I knew we had some people that's going to be out for a couple of minutes. But like I said, just staying in the gym, staying confident, and believing in myself.
I think the one thing that we've noticed is your rebounds are up, your assists are up. Maybe that three-point shot isn't falling for you like we're used to seeing, but that hasn't prevented you from doing other things. How much have you been thinking about what it is that you need to do to help this team win, or whatever it is to do that
right,
helps
Right, yeah, I'm in a little slump right now, but it's all good. We're just going to keep on putting in the work, and we're going to keep on believing in it, and it's going to come.
It's all good, Will Regan.
That's what you got to do. Shooter's going to shoot.
Shoot.
Hey, Jeremy, congratulations. This one was a wild game, back and forth, big deficits, big comebacks, big runs. Congratulations
appreciate
on the win.
Appreciate it.
Jeremy Harris, our player of the game here on our ESPN Plus broadcast. And, Will, this one was as fun as we thought it would be. Maybe not so much early. Nate seemed like he was a little worried there at one point. But what does it say about this Bulls team to come from behind like that, come from a bad start and still wind up with a win at 14 points?
Well, it shows that they're not perfect. There's flaws that this team has to play through, and they learned how to play a game from behind, maybe without two of their best players at full strength. But that's the depth of this team coming through and showing that they are a deep team and can rally when they need to.
Seventh consecutive win for the Bulls against Central Michigan. Buffalo goes to 20-3 and 8-2 in the MAC and completes a doubleheader sweep as the women win the first game. The men win here, 90-76, our final. Next game for the Bulls men's team, Tuesday at Akron on ESPN+. For Will Regan, my name is Paul Peck, our entire crew. This has been a production of ESPN. Yeah.